morning, or depending when you're watching this, good afternoon, good evening, or good night. My name's Ross, and as always, told out of Voice of Radio. So today, I want to show you what I think I can confidently call right now the very best Pokemon trading card game deck in the world. Japan had a national championships this past weekend. There were 1,300 players. It was in the format where essentially Evolving Skies is legal. And we had a definitive winner. Yes, I know it was Japan's national championships. It wasn't really a worldwide tournament, but it was a 1,300 person tournament. It was extremely competitive. It was played in the format with Evolving Skies legal. I feel confident saying that until we have some better information, this is the best deck. However, I do need to mention before we get going into Shadow Rider Calyrex that Malamar might actually be the best deck. And the reason is the lovely Antoine Boulay, and we talk about Antoine a lot on this channel because Antoine is awesome and helps us out amazingly, went to this tournament, played Malamar, went 8-1 in day one, qualified as the 8th seed, beat the eventual winner in the final round of Swiss, made it to top 16, secured a day two Worlds invite, and dropped for personal reasons. And just to interrupt myself here, I did have a quick chat with Antoine to make sure it was all right to tell this story. And Antoine is not only cool with, but would prefer me to say, dropped to go and get vaccinated. That's right. Made top 16 at Nationals, dropped to go and get vaccinated. That, ladies and gentlemen, is pretty gosh darn cool. That's a baller move. Okay, now back to the regular video. What that means is that Antoine made it to top 16, taking only one loss in the tournament, beat the eventual winner on the way there, was in a phenomenal position to have a really good run, and I still believe strongly take down the tournament, and then couldn't complete the tournament. So I just want it out there that although Shadow Rider Calyrex did win, and as far as I'm concerned has proven to be the best deck, please bear in mind that Antoine played Malamar and I believe could well have won, well, definitely could have won the tournament. I think there's a pretty good chance would have. Hey-ho. So Shadow Rider Calyrex then. I told you when this card was released that it was the best card I'd seen since Zoroark. I expected it to start absolutely crushing the metagame. Didn't do so initially in Japan. Has been doing so in North America, Europe, etc. It has been crushing the online tournaments and has now taken down the biggest tournament in Japan. Biggest tournament in the world for a long time. Incidentally, also took at least third place. Is a phenomenal deck. And Shadow Rider Calyrex is one of those where everything about it is good. The ability lets you attach a psychic energy from your hand to a bent psychic Pokemon and then draw two cards. That is energy acceleration and draw power in one ability. And then the attack for a minimum 3 colorless energy does 10 damage base plus 30 more for each psychic energy attached to all of your Pokemon. So you spread your energy around, but you still get to do a whole bunch of extra damage. And, like, at its core, Shadow Rider Calyrex decks are, I'm going to spread damage around and smash with Shadow Rider Calyrex. Obviously, there is more to it. We will get there in a moment. But that is, at the heart, what this deck actually does. And I'm going to be honest with you, ladies and gentlemen. It's a pretty gosh darn phenomenal card. And I think it's fair to say that it is one of the best cards we've seen. Certainly in a very long time. It might go down as an all-time great. And I mean that sincerely with no hyperbole. And the main partner we see here is Alcrem EV Max. And I adore this, ladies and gentlemen. I absolutely adore this. Alcremie was one of those Pokemon that when it released, everyone was like, nah, it's not good enough. It's not good enough. And now it is an integral part of the best deck in the format. The third place deck also played Alcremie. Alcremie is a phenomenal card. Alcremie, and this happens all the time. Probably the most extreme version of this was Celebi Prime, that was a junk $2 Pokemon Prime, and then became part of one of the very best decks in the format for a long time. Alcremie VMAX was not thought of very highly. It now really is. For one colorless energy, you get to search your deck for a psychic energy and attach to each of your bench Pokemon, so up to 5 here. Clearly good for getting set up, but also that's an extra 150 damage for Shadow Rider Calyrex. If you can pull this off without getting KO'd, that's kind of amazing. But also has a pretty redonkulous attack here that for two psychic energy minimum does 60 damage for each energy you discard, and you can discard any amount of energy from any of your Pokemon. So clearly here you pile energy on with Shadow Rider Calyrex and go for a bit of the old sweep. But if you need a big attack, Alchemy VMAX hits more, pretty much double minus 10. But you discard the energy, you don't keep it. But when you need a really big KO, Alchemy VMAX is here for you. Not to mention the lovely attack, which also gets to just get a lot of energy on the field, and this is pretty good. The V, for what it's worth, for free energy does do 100 damage and stop the defending basic Pokemon attacking next turn, but they can switch around. It's fairly easily played around, but there are situations where that could be a useful attack, so it is worth mentioning. Now, there are a couple of tag teams that also make their way into the deck here, one of which is Trevenant and Dusknoir, a card which, frankly, a lot of people aren't a huge fan of because it's a super, super annoying card. And it has been for the entire time it's been legal. You see, what we've got here, the main attack is Night Watch. For free energy, you do 150 damage, and you choose two random cards from your opponent's hand, and they shuffle them into their deck. So you've got just hand control here. And bearing in mind, you can accelerate the energy easily with Shadow Rider Calyrex, so getting this rolling isn't going to be an issue. Yeah, it's pretty gosh darn good. It does have a two energy attack that at the end of your opponent's next turn, the defending Pokemon is knocked out. But if you add an extra psychic energy, you also discard all energy from your opponent's active. There will be times where you can take a big KO here if your opponent has a low hand and they're out of switching cards or whatever. It's not the main reason to play the card, you're playing it for Night Watch. But it's kind of cool, and it is an option. The other one we've got here is Gengar and Mimikyu, and I like Gengar and Mimikyu. It's, well, it's frankly extremely harsh. For two energy, you got Poltergeist, 50 damage for each trainer card in your opponent's hand, and that is trainer, not item, so all the different kinds count. And for a single energy, you stop your opponent playing any cards during their next turn, and with a second energy on there, both players draw, so they've got seven cards in their hand. Hopefully your opponent draws a bunch of trainers, and you can punish them the following turn with Poltergeist. This is for when your opponent has a large hand, or you need an emergency KO and you can't do it with Alchemy. It's a nice emergency attack. It's nice if your opponent gets a large hand. And it's a kind of, if they keep a large hand, you can punish them with Poltergeist. If they don't keep a large hand, you can punish them with Trevenant and Dusknoir. And I kind of like this. These are very fun cards. We then have one copy of Crobat just for draw. When you play it, you draw until you've got six cards in your hand. And a copy of Dedenne for draw. Discard your hand and draw six cards. And then we've got one copy of that Marshadow that still sees a whole bunch of play, that when it's on the bench, you can discard it to get rid of a stadium. And that Marshadow, it just sits there to get rid of stadiums. Any stadium your opponent might be relying on, Marshadow will be there. Now, obviously, when it comes down to energy, we don't need to go into a huge amount of detail. There are 13 energy here, and they're all psychic. But bearing in mind, Shadow Rider Calyrex does damage based on psychic energy, although there are special energies that when attached will count. But also Shadow Rider Calyrex attaches psychic energy with the ability, and only basic psychic energy will count, so it kind of has to just be basic psychic energy. Now, in terms of the supporter line, it is exactly what we would expect here. We've got Professor's Research and Marnie as your supporter cards of choice. Professor's Research, you discard your hand, draw seven cards. Marnie, both players shovel the hand into their, well, bottom of their deck. And then you get five cards, your opponent gets four. And then you've got Boss's Orders for a little bit of gusting. Bring a Pokemon from the bench to the active so you can choose who to KO. That is what we expect to see in every deck, so nothing particularly unusual there. Moving over, outside of supporter cards, we've got, in terms of Pokemon Search, we got four copies of Quick Ball, which shouldn't surprise anyone. It's a Pokemon deck. Pokemon decks play four copies of Quick Ball. You search your basics, it's phenomenal. We've then got four copies of Fog Crystal, and Fog Crystal in a deck like this is absolutely phenomenal because you either search for a basic psychic Pokemon or a basic psychic energy. Again, the card says psychic energy, but remember, special only count when attached. So if you're searching for a psychic energy, it will be a basic. And essentially here in the early game, you get your Pokemon. And then in the mid to late game, you get your energy, which can be attached with Shadow Rider Calyrex to draw cards. And the synergy here is just absolutely beautiful. We then do see two copies of Pokemon Communication, which allow you to swap a Pokemon in your hand for one in your deck, which, you know, you are playing a bunch of evolved Pokemon here. Your VMAXs are evolutions, so it's nice to have something that can search them out. We've got three copies of Switch. Lets you switch your active with one of your bench. It's a staple in like every deck, so you can switch around and make sure you got the right Pokemon in the active. It's not an exciting card, but it is one that you basically need to play. We have a couple copies of Air Balloon here, because it reduces your retreat cost by 2, and that's pretty important, frankly, because it means that you can get your Pokemon out the active. It means it is easier to retreat, and that is a very good thing. Oh, and there is one copy of Evolution Incense to also get your evolved Pokemon. So, yeah, that's in there as well. Nice to have a fair amount of Pokemon search. That is pretty gosh darned important. We've then got some one-offs. We've got one copy of Reset Stamp. It's Reset Stamp. You play it to put your opponent down to a new hand equal to their remaining prizes. It sees play in like every deck because it's amazing. It's great in the late game. It's a phenomenal comeback card. We got one copy of Chaotic Swell. This is your stadium of choice. It is the ultimate counter stadium. You play it down to replace a stadium, but then if your opponent wants to play a new stadium over Chaotic Swell, they play it and it immediately gets discarded without doing anything. It's basically a phenomenal option to basically just always get rid of any stadium, and it means you're getting rid of kind of two stadiums or one card, which is pretty awesome. We've then got one copy of Ordinary Rod. It gets back a couple of Pokemon and basic energy. Pretty gosh darn important to, well, get your Pokemon and energy back. Not to mention, of course, that you will sometimes need that energy so that you can attach it with Shadow Rider Calyrex and draw more cards. Speaking of getting your energy back, we also have a copy of Energy Recycler here, which will take 5 basic energy and shuffle them back into your deck. Again, you need your energy to attach, but also to draw cards. And also because you're discarding it with Alchemy, which means you're going to run out of energy a bit faster than you would in some other decks. Now, I'm going to show you the list here. It is on the screen. And what's a little bit weird is I was going around Japanese Twitter and I knew that Shadow Rider Calyrex with Alchemy had gone and won the Japanese National Championships. And I saw a tweet with this list saying the best deck. And I'm like, right, well, that must be the winning deck. And it is. But it's actually the winning seniors deck. And what I was going to do was re-record the last bit of this video to make sure I was only talking about the Masters deck, and then I went, well, hang on a second. This is a phenomenal list that won the National Championships. Maybe we keep it in and just add a bit on at the end. So this is the Seniors winning list. If we take a little bit of a look at the Masters winning list, you will notice, of course, that it is very, very similar. So you will see that the Pokemon line is basically the same and is a Shadow Rider Calyrex VMAX deck with a 2-2 Alchemy VMAX line. We've still got one Gengar and Mimikyu, one Dusknoir and Trevenant, one Dedenne, one Crobat, one Marshadow. We still got a real reliance on those Fog Crystals because they are amazing. The only real substantive change we see in the deck is that there are two copies of Training Court as opposed to the one copy of Chaotic Swell. There is a different stadium being played here. Like I say, the other cards are occasionally one or two out in terms of trainers and all, but it's really not a big deal. Now, Training Court is actually a really good card in this deck. I am a big fan of it. I like it more than I like Chaotic Swell because it lets you put a basic energy from your discard pile into your hand. But bearing in mind, if it's late in the game, you can have a zero card hand for whatever reason, or you can be reset stamped down to one or whatever. And then Training Court gets you an energy, you attach an energy and draw two cards, and then from there you're off. So I really do like the inclusion of Training Court here. So there we go. Not just one Japanese Nationals winning deck list of Shadow Rider Calyrex with Alchemy, but two, because frankly, this is awesome. And I could take the seniors winning list off the thumbnail and put the Masters one up instead, but I think we should give a little bit of love to seniors. So I've already made the thumbnail and I'm not taking it off. Frankly, there are two winning lists in this video now, and that should be pretty gosh darn good for you guys to start testing. Make no mistake about it, this is the best deck, and I don't think there's much of a counter-argument at the moment. Maybe when Evolving Skies comes out over here and we start having a whole bunch of tournaments, maybe something will change, but I don't think at this stage you can make any real good counter-argument to this being the best deck. But I want to know what you think about it, so let me know in the comment section. Go nuts! Be nice! And then make sure you like this video, subscribe to this channel, follow me on Twitter at TheWasi, and Twitch for some live action at twitch.tv/PTCGRadio. If you want to support the channel, get some bonus podcasts and all that good stuff, head on over to patreon.com/PTCGRadio, where you can do exactly that. But by far the most important thing, as always, look after yourself till next time, would ya? Thank you very much for watching. My name's Ross, and you've been watching PTCG Radio.